Pilots boarding starting.
Hey, what's up? What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another stream. Today we're sitting in Canada on the ground at the Pass Regional Airport, taking a flight over in the ATR to Winnipeg. Flight time should be about an hour and some change. Ground crew is loading up the baggages. We're not going to see any passengers board. I don't have a GSX profile for this airport. But we're going to jump right into the ATR and get us up and ready to go. It's been a while since I've flown this aircraft, so bear with me. Let's go with battery. External power can come on. Bring the aircraft to life. Let's arm our emergency lights. Seatbelt sign, no device sign can come on. Logo lights can come on. Nav lights can come on. Okay, sim is frozen for a second. Hopefully they come back. Okay, let's come downstairs and set some panel lights. We are flying on VATSIM. We do not have any ATC control online at the moment, so we're gonna jump right into our EFB. Import our flight plan. It's already imported. I'm gonna come over to SimBrief really quick and check to make sure that we have the correct amount of fuel and payload on the aircraft. Set fuel. Set flight plan. Set payload. Let's come down to our FMC and let's get set up and ready to go. So we are departing runway 13. Don't have any SIDs. Gonna go execute. And for our arrival, I'll plan that. Actually, we could probably plan that now. Let's see what the winds are. Let's save that. Actually, let's go to our performance page. Actually, let's go to our menu. Let's go in it. Position in it. We're gonna go GPS position. Let's go back. Nav. All right. Let's go weight. Let's go ahead and verify our payload. Hey, what's up, Penguin? Yeah, I won't be active as much. Because tests tomorrow. Any active ATC? No, there's no active ATC here at the moment. But I understand school come first, so make sure you get that out the way. This is always going to be here. You can always watch the playback or the replay. But yeah, doing this flight because you requested, and it's very interesting out here today. It's was raining. I think it was passing clouds. Or was is that snow? It looks like flurries. Is it snowing where you at? yeah, let's jump back in our FMC here to our perf. Actually, no, menu. Lost track. Let's go in it. Sorry, wait. All right, we're going to put this in manually. For fuel, we need 5,185. And for our zero fuel weight, we're looking at 454.90. Oh, okay, okay. Oh, wow, cool. So, yes, all right, so fuel, let's set up fuel. Is this all in? Fuel board, zero fuel weight. Okay, that's all set. All right, cool. Let's go to our perf. Takeoff speed's gonna be, it's actually snowing. Performance, let's go rev, let's go wet, or snow, that should have changed, but we plan accordingly. Runway, transition, altitude, all that stuff is, not going to worry too much about that. For cruise altitude, we are looking at 17,000. Oh wow, mom's eyes picking up snow right now. Yeah, it's just looking like it's pretty nasty out here. I wonder how it is in Winnipeg when I get there. I have to check the weather and stuff. Alright, everything here looks good. Performance, that's looking good. Cruise altitude is in. Alright, let's focus on our flight plan really quick. And let me double check and see what Winnipeg is looking like. Oh, also, let's go tune into Unicom frequency, which is going to be 122.8. What else? Oh, okay. Let's go here. Standby mode is on. Making sure I'm squawking mode Charlie, and I am. Alright, I'm gonna check the weather for Winnipeg and see. So SimBrief is giving us 1.8. Just gonna verify and see if that's what they're actually landing on right now. And then we go ahead and plan for our arrival. It's a very short flight, so I'm not gonna do this in cruise. I'm gonna try and get it out the way now. No problem, bro. No problem. I love flying to Canada too, so, and I love these small regional airports. Cruise altitude, I believe it's 17,000. Yeah, 17,000 on the cruise. So let me check Winnipeg real quick and see what the runway, or the what runway they actually land on. Okay, so yeah, in Winnipeg, they are landing on 1.8, so we're going to jump inside the cockpit and get this plant as well. So, we're probably, where cruise altitude is this? Base version? What do you mean base version? Of the aircraft or of the sim? Alright, so let's plan for 1/8 Zulu. It's gonna be an RNAV approach. Yeah, 1/8 Zulu. And our star is going to be Anbil 3. And for transition, we can do Iklus. We'll go ahead and execute. And we are looking good. Don't have an ATIS. I'm trying to find an ATIS on this airport and I cannot find one. Don't have an ATIS for Winnipeg as well. Interesting. Alright, for our takeoff speeds and stuff, let's get that plant. I'm gonna climb up to 17,000. Is the airport an add-on? Yes, so this airport, I actually found it on, gosh, this thing's freezing up. I found this airport on flightsim.to. Yeah, so this is an add-on. This is not, it's a default, but it's like a custom airport. It's not a payware. I know a payware would have way more details. But this is actually, I'm pretty sure I looked at the reviews, it's better than the default airport. So we're gonna be rocking with this. Oh yeah, so we're doing 17,000. That's in. Barrel, I don't know the barrel, so we're just gonna keep it like that for now. Takeoff speeds and all that good stuff is already in. Alright, cool. flight director is on already. LNAV and VNAV is on. And we should be ready for pushback. Looks like GSX is not doing anything, so let them know we are ready for a pushback. Before I do that, let's go ahead and start up engine number 1. So let's go collision. Beacon light can come on. And where's anti-ice? We worry about that once we get started up. Alright, what I'm forgetting here. Alright, fuel pump can come on. We're gonna go start A. But before I do that, let's go GSX. Let me know, prepare for pushback. Yeah, GSX is doing this wonky thing. So let's go reset GSX. I got to go for a bit. See ya. You know, all right, I'll be here when you get back. Or if not, catch the replay. Until then, I'll see ya. Enjoy your study and your homework. Prepare for pushback. All right, for realism, we could do de-icing. The vehicles are coming now. We can close all our doors. All so forgot the starter pack X. Let's do that now.
Confirm aircraft is ready for treatment. We begin treatment now and observe. Fluid type, 1. Concentration at 50%. I will call you back when ready.
Another thing too, chat, we're not gonna do any pushback. We're just gonna get up out of here. There's no way to push back. Alright, let's go start. Once this get up to about 17%, are we gonna go feather? Let's go feather into number 1. And we're going to reset the cooltown script. We do not need pushback.
De-icing and anti-icing completed. Anti-icing code is fluid type. 1. Concentration at 50%. I'm disconnected. Good day.
When you find your seat, please be sure to place your larger carry-on items in the overhead bin.
Let's go start engine number 1 to auto.
Unless you're in a front row, please place all of your items in the overhead bin. If you have any trouble finding a location for your carry-on items, please let a flight attendant know and we would be happy to assist you. If the overhead bin is full, please make sure you close it as a courtesy to other passengers. Please double check that all your items are put away.
We have
so
one good engine.
Clear and other passengers can make their way.
Now let's go start.
If you're in an emergency
2.
Exit row, please
pumpkin
please
come
exit
on.
Responsibilities in the car.
And let's start up engine
if
number 2.
If you're not able to comply
2.
With these actions, please let a flight attendant know so that way you can be reseated. Now's the time to get out any last minute text messages if you need to, but we ask that once you depart from the gate, put away any laptops or tablets. Thank you and welcome aboard.
We have 17%, let's go feather. Let's select flaps 1. All right, let's go engine number 2 to auto. Windshield, defrost can come on, and anti-ice. Oxygen supply can come on.
We're ready to go when you are.
Anti-ice can come on.
Gentlemen, and welcome aboard flight 123 with service to Winnipeg. Our flight time will be roughly 1 hour and 21 minutes. Please note the cabin door is now closed. We ask that you make sure that all devices are in airplane mode and your larger devices are now shut down and stowed.
Right,
if you have
we
not
need
already,
to go
please
true.
Fasten your seatbelt and verify it is low and tight across your lap. Your tray tables and seatbacks must
true.
Be in the full upright position
for the should be right
cabin crew secure doors for
right, true is on. Stern power can come off. And we are ready for taxis. Crank can go to off. Taxi light can come on.
Please direct your complete attention to the flight attendants as they demonstrate the safety features of our aircraft. You will notice a light illuminated
above. Alright, let's do a flight control check.
This light is illuminated. Please fasten your seatbelt low and tight across
right the aileron, down,
fasten,
down,
insert the metal fittings into one another.
Left aileron, down, up.
To release your seatbelt,
right rudder, left rudder.
We suggest that you keep your seatbelt seatbelt fastened throughout the flight as you may experience unexpected.
And let's taxi. Let's release parking brake.
Please take a few moments to now locate one of the several emergency exits on this aircraft. In some cases, your nearest exit may be behind.
No traffic here on the ground.
In case of an emergency,
we're gonna call our intentions.
Aircraft, there is lighting on the floor that will guide you towards the exit. In the event that the cabin loses pressure, an oxygen mask will drop right in front of you.
Pass traffic. Calm. 123 taxi and 13 via Alpha.
Presence strap is necessary and breathe normally. Although the bag does not weigh oxygen,
let's taxi to the runway.
If you're traveling with a child or someone who requires assistance, secure your mask first and then assist others. Keep your mask on until a member of the crew advises you.
I believe I forgot to do something. Alright, let's disconnect ground power and wheel checks.
When instructed to do so, open the plastic pouch and remove the vest. Flip it over your head. Wrap the straps around your waist and buckle at the front. Pull the strap to tight. To inflate the vest, pull firmly on the red cord only when exiting the aircraft. If your life vest does not inflate automatically, blow into the mouthpieces for manual inflation. Each vest is equipped with a whistle and light. If necessary, your seat cushion can be used as a secondary flotation device. Please securely stow your personal items. Make sure your seatbelts are fastened and seat backs and tray tables are in their full upright position. We remind you that this is a non-smoking flight. Tampering with, disabling, or destroying the smoke detectors located in the lavatories is prohibited by law. All of this information and more can be found at the safety card located in the seat back in front of you. We suggest reading this and let us know if you have any questions. Thank you for flying with us, and we hope you enjoy your flight.
Takeoff speed is going to be 127. Pass traffic, cab 123, line up in apartment 13. Pass traffic. Alright, about to enter the runway. Whoa. Stop for a second. Landing lights, wing lights, strobe lights all can come on. Chrono can come on. And enjoy the departure. Alright, let's go Toga. Let's try this again. Oh, trim. That's what it is. Oops, yes, I'm gonna try. Where's your trim? We need for trim. Takeoff. We need 1.14. Mm-hmm. Let's try this again. Alright, cool. Let's go Toga. Go climb out. Continue on the climb. Let's clean up our flaps. Watch our speed, watch our altitude. Can come, or taxi light can come off. Watch my speed. I don't like how my speed is falling. We're in climb mode. IAS. Try to get our speed up. on 10,000. Let's go clean up our lantern lights, logo lights, and wing lights. Overpassing those clouds. Once you get out the clouds, you can turn off for any ice. just go cruise mode. flight's going good. Coming up on top of the descent in about 5-10 minutes. Let's see. After me do, we need to be at like around 11,000 at Anvil. So yeah, we're gonna start our ascent probably right after Mevdu or a little bit before or after, one or two. Aircraft flies slower than what I'm used to, because you know, like the jet engines are not faster. So 80 miles, it's been saying 80 miles for a little while now, but we're slowly creeping. Have you ever flown on the ATR in real life? Oh, it's not working at the top? Damn. I'll have to reset it. Oh, okay, okay. Yeah, me either. I never flown on an IRL either. The ATA on the bottom, though, should be pretty accurate. It's showing us 43 minutes. Well, it's given us 43 minutes, but we should be on the ground in another half an hour. And we're about to start our ascent in about like another 5-10 minutes. We're trying to get close as possible to Mevdu, and then we're gonna see if we can make it at Anvil for 11,000. Digging this livery, it's pretty nice. Calm air. Okay, I know you gotta study multitasking, but yeah, I seen a little bit. No problem, bro. placebo sign to come on, and let's descend down to 11,000. Let's go vertical descent. It's already set right now. That 10 minutes is going to be 2.99.5. Reduce our speed. Starting to overspeed. Creeping down to 11,000.
Wi-Fi related tasks show any larger electronics.
from this waypoint, we're going to get down to 6,000. And then we got to bring our speed back to 230. Let's go climb. Speed back. Alright, let's go. Landing lights can come on. Taxi lights, ring lights, logo. Get down to 2,000. Yeah, let's go 3,000 actually. Really close. Weather is a lot better out here. I can actually see the terrain in the background. on 10 miles. Let's put our flaps one. Oh, shoot. Actually, maybe at 160 on the speed for that one. All right, speed is coming back. Winnipeg traffic, cab 123, inbound for runway 18. We're gonna loop, we're gonna vectors, and then come around and then get established. Cause I gotta bring my speed back. Up speed is coming back. Let's go flaps one. Bring our speed up. Let's go flaps, full flaps. Let's drop our gears. Let's drop gear. We're gonna go Myocraft. Start the recording. Fully established. Flight attendants, please be seated for a landing. Checklist complete. Landing.
200. 50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
Goes down. Manual break in. Winnipeg traffic, calm air 123, clear off runway 18. Alright, clean up our flaps. Stop recording. And we made it to Winnipeg. Pull up to the apron. Let's go landing lights off. Taxi lights, wing lights. Strobe lights. And let's taxi over to the terminal. Park at this gate right here. So let's set parking brake. Engine 1 and 2 can go to Feather.
We need to stop the engines to request ground services.
Go ahead and stop engine number 1. External power can come on. Let's turn off engine number 2. And we made it, y'all. Landing rate on that one is going to be negative 220 with a G of 0.92. Let's go ahead and close that out. And we made it 17 minutes early on pack X. Strobe lights. Oh, no. Beacon light can now come off. No seatbelt sign, no device sign can come off. And let's see if GSX will give us a deboarding.
This parking is too small for your aircraft. The boarding requested.
Let's open up the doors. We'll check all that good stuff and come on. Sweet, we made it, chat. Alright, we can getting ready for the replay. Let's go ahead and close out the stuff in the background that I have going on. And we actually gonna go ahead and we're not gonna see any animation. I have to get a GSX profile for this damn airport or this plane.
Parking is too small for your aircraft.
Just gonna go ahead and reset. Now let's jump back, close all these doors. Let's go to ready for taxi and get ready for
this
a replay.
Parking is too small for your aircraft.
Oh, we also need to close out pack bags. Check to make sure seatbelt sign is off. Oh, that's probably why. Nope, still won't turn it off. Alright, I'm just gonna close back X at this point. Let's go flaps full and let's check out the replay. Oh, one more thing. I have to disconnect from the network. Try not to float it, put it down on the numbers. Try not to tail strike it, okay. That was a solid touchdown. From the back of the different view. Solid landing. A little bit floaty, but it's a small aircraft. I want to take this moment to say thank you all for checking out the stream. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, don't forget to smash down the like button. Until then, I see you again on the next one. See ya. Peace.
Don't sing. 100. 50. 40.
30. 20. 10. Don't sink.